How to create a financial year in Excel. This Excel accounts tutorial will not only show you how to generate a financial year in Excel, but if you've ever wondered, can I use a pivot table with a financial year, then you're in the right place. I'm Simon, a real-life Excel trainer, and this is Computer Tutoring. Okay, so if you've been following along in this Excel accounts tutorial series, then you will have created this spreadsheet. If you haven't got it and you want to follow along precisely, then I'll give you the link that you can download. Now, what we're going to do to create this pivot table with financial year is first create a formula to work out the financial year and then apply it to a pivot table. We'll then see a sorting problem, which means that we want April at the top and we'll have January at the top. So we'll use custom lists to overcome this problem. And then finally, I'll show you how to create a financial quarter formula. So let's get started. What I'm going to do here is go to sheet one, right click on description, go down to, and we're going to insert table columns to the left. And then we will start off with the financial year. Okay, and then this is the formula. Now you can see what I've done here is I have, if I just zoom back, just use this little drop-down list on the right-hand side to expand my formula bar. And I'd suggest you do this for particularly complicated calculations or ones that you're going to put down an extra line. Hopefully this one's not too complicated, but I'll keep it slow and steady. So what we're going to do is create an if statement. And the logic of this is basically if the month is January, February, or March, it's the previous financial year in this one. And if it's anything from April onwards, it will be this year and next year. So we're going to start off with an equals, type in IFF for if, open bracket. And then what I need to do is know what the month is on that, what the current month is. So for instance, I'm going to click on date here. And basically, I'm checking to see what the month is for that date. Now that's what month number that date is. So is it one, is it two, is it three, or whatever. So what I then need to do is to check, get rid of the comma, if it's less than four. So if the month is less than four, we know it's January, February, and March. It's the previous year and this year, that financial year. So I'm going to hold down Alt and press Enter on the keyboard. So it's Alt and Enter, and that wraps the code around to the next line, or the function down to the next line. And I like to separate them up, it makes it easier. Just press space a few times to bring it in. So now I'm going to type in year. Year, that's a long year, isn't it? So year, and click on the date again. Minus one. And then I'm going to what's known as concatenate. I know it's a big word that basically means join together. And I'm joining together whatever the previous year is here and a little dash in between. And then I'm going to concatenate that with the current year. If you want to know where the ampersand is or the little and symbol, it's shift and seven on your keyboard. And I put that in double quotes. Great, excellent. So what I'm going to do is press a comma and Alt Enter to go down to the next line because I need to put, say for instance, if it isn't less than four, say it's four or onwards, that if the month is four or onwards. So what I'm going to do here is going to be the current year. So year and the date again. Brilliant. Concatenate. You remember that word there? Concatenate. We're going to bring it together with next year. So that will be year again. And click on that there, that's great, plus one, and then I'm going to close off the bracket. So there we go, so there we have our logic there. So either if it's less than four, we know it's January, February, and March, so the financial year will be, well, 2019 to 2020, and if not, it would be 2020 to 2021. If I press enter, let's have a quick look-see and see what I've got. And as you can see, I've got that financial year. Looks good here. If I scroll down until I get to April dates, let's have a look here. That should be a crossover there. You can see if I just move in a bit. So there we go. There's the 31st of March, financial year 2019 to 2020. But now the 1st of April is 2020 to 2021. Great. So now we need to apply this to a pivot table. Apply this financial year to a pivot table. So this is how you do it. I'm going to click anywhere in the table. I'm then going to then click on table design at the top of the screen just here, and then going to click on summarize with a pivot table over here. That's great. I'm going to do this on a new worksheet. So just make sure, see, it's picking up the name of the data, sales of the table, sales data, go into a new worksheet here, click on OK. Okay, brilliant. So now we're going to apply our financial year. Now, if you don't see financial year in the list, you see it's not there at the moment. So, oh, it's gone. So what I need to do is just right click on the pivot table and go to refresh to refresh the pivot table. It will then update the pivot table, and there I can see financial year. So I can drag financial year down into rows, and it's appearing there in the pivot table. Let me just use this little zoom slider to just make this spreadsheet a bit bigger. And then I'm interested in received, so I'm going to drag received into values, and now I can see this broken up by financial year. It's looking good. Let me just reformat this number of the received amount. Go right click on the cells, go to number format, and I'm going to format that as accounting. That's great. So now I want to add in month. I don't have a month field, but I can extract the month from the date. So if I get in closely here and then drag date all the way down and just underneath financial years, you see it comes up financial year, and it's also got years and dates. Well, I don't want year there, so I'm just going to drag year out. I hope you can see that there. So I was just used, just in case you were behind me, I just that was behind me there. I use that to drag the year out. Can you see? Oh, there we go. Get out of the way. So just drag that one out there. Excellent. Now, as you can see, there's a tiny little problem here. We can see January is the first month, and it shouldn't be. It should be April. And that's where we would use custom lists. That's how we can use custom lists to sort data or to sort months by financial year. So first thing we're going to do is let's create our custom list or the order of the list. So instead of typing it in manually, we can do that a little quicker in Excel. I'm going to type, clicking I1, it doesn't matter which cell, we're just using this to import. Clicking I1, type in APR for April. I then use the auto fill down here to drag this all the way down to March. Let's get to March, there we go. That's great, that's gonna be our custom list. Then to bring, or to use the custom list, first I'm gonna get you to click on File, just in the top left-hand corner, and then we're gonna click on Options, just down in the bottom left-hand corner. And then from the categories on this left-hand side here, we're going to click on Advanced, if we do that. And then we're going to scroll all the way down to the Edit Custom Lists button, so we can see that. So we're going to click on Edit Custom Lists. Now, oops, this is one I've done earlier, so I'm just going to delete that one. Let's get that one out there. Yeah, we go. So what I can do is, you can see, if I just zoom back a tiny bit, but you can see that the custom list here is already picking up this list here, like so. If not, you could just reselect it if you need to, but all I need to do is click on this import button, which will bring it in. That looks good. Click on OK, and now I've got a custom list. That's great. Click on OK there. That's brilliant. So now I've got this custom list. I can get rid of that. Press delete on the keyboard. Don't need it anymore. So now I'm going to go across and click on this drop down list just here. And I want to sort by the date, which is the month in this case, because we don't have any date lower in the hierarchy. And then I'm going to go to More Sort Options, and then click on the More Options button at the bottom. I'm then going to untick the sort automatically every time the report is updated. And I'm going to choose my custom list here, April through to March. And then I'm going to click on OK. And then I can then sort it as, let's say for instance I sort it ascending by dates. That's great. Click on OK, and now I can see April is the first month. Now, you may have remembered in the introduction to the right of me, I think there was a pivot table that had the financial year as a slicer. That's a good option, so let's do that. So I'm going to click in the pivot table, go up to Pivot Table Analyze at the top, and then click on the Insert Slicer button that you can just see here. And then I'm going to choose the financial year option, go down to the bottom and click on OK, and there we have our financial year. Just to make look a little better, I'm going to change the order of the financial year. I want the latest one at the top, so I'm going to right click on the slicer and go down to and click on Slicer Settings, and then I'm going to change the order, the sort order, to descending, and click on OK. And now I can see the most recent financial year is at the top. Let me use the resize handles around the slicer, and I'm going to drag the slicer using the header at the top just to the right here. And now I can just select my particular financial year that I'm interested in. The last thing I'm interested in or want to do is to work out the financial quarter using this pivot table. Now, just like with the financial year, we'll first have to go back to the table and create a financial quarter calculation. So let's go back to sheet one where our data is. I'm going to right click on description and go to insert because I want to insert columns to the left. Oops, bounced in and out. There we go. Interested in financial quarter. So I'm going to call it financial QTR. There we go. And then what I'm going to do is take advantage of what they call the choose function in Excel. Now, the choose function is a nice simple to get you, actually so simple, sometimes we overcomplicate it. Now, the way it works basically is, firstly, let's type the name of the function equals choose, open bracket. Now, the first argument or instructions for this choose function is a number, any number. So, for instance, I'm going to need to know what month it is. So I'm going to type in month. And then click on date just over here. So I know, okay, whatever number month it is. So if it's January, it would return 1. February, it would return 2. And March, it would return a 3. Now, based on that, what would happen here is if it was a 1, it would choose the second argument in this list. So for instance, if I said typed a 4 in here, if month was January, which would be 1, the quarter would be 4. So I would type a 4 in this list here. Same with February. If it was February, it would also be quarter 4 in the financial year. And the same with March. So the 3 4s in there. The same as well, if it was going to be April, May or June, that would be the first quarter in the financial year. So I'm typing 1 1 1 and so on. The second for going on to June, July, August and so on. And 3 3 3 and close that one off there. Brilliant. So just to explain a little bit with this one here, let me just, let's see if I can do this here. That gets really close. Brilliant. Excellent. So depending on what this number here returns, so if this returns, say, for instance, a number 2, yeah, it would then select this number here. Yeah. So if it was then a number 3 or so on, let's just go back here. Let me just see if I can do my typing in again. So if it chose a number, let's say, for instance, let's do a harder one. Let's say if it was a number 5 that it chose there, then what this one would go into is it would count along 1 2 3 4 5. It would then return this number. When I say return, display that as an answer. Great. You can press enter. Let's just zoom back and see if this one works. Now, at the moment, you can see it sucked the formatting across. I love that term. Thanks to whoever said that one. I'm just going to control shift and the down arrow to select all of my financial year there. And there's a nice little shortcut to convert the format of that back to general. It's control shift and the tilde or hashtag if you're using a UK keyboard or the tilde key. And that basically converts the formatting to general. So you can see, there we go, the formatting there at the top is now general. Let's use our concatenate because I want a Q in front of the actual number. So let's just get in close here so we can actually be clear. Click on this and then I want a Q in quotation marks and then concatenate whatever the result of the choose function is. That looks good. Let's just press enter. Now we can see our financial quarters here. Let's go and apply that to the pivot table. So we're going to go back to our sheet with the pivot table. Here it is here. Going to right click on the pivot table and go to refresh. So we need to do that because we want to see financial quarter. And there we can see financial quarter. So let's get in really close with a financial quarter and we can drag that all the way down and we can wedge it. Hope you can see that there. Let me get out of the way in between financial year and financial quarter. Hopefully you can see that there. So if you just look, let me just move myself a little bit out of the way and then let me just get in a bit closer over here. So now you can see financial year, financial quarter, date. And more importantly, in the pivot table, it's separated by financial year and financial quarter. So there we go. How'd you get along with that? Hopefully you've been able to follow along, but if not, I'll give you all the calculations below. So if you just want to copy and paste or take your time, then please do so. Have a look at our website, computertutoring.co.uk, for the completed file. And also if you want to download the starter file as well. So now you know, how to create a financial year in Excel. You'll know the answer to the question, can I use a pivot table with a financial year? And I've also looked at the sorting problem, using custom lists to overcome sorting problem. So these custom lists, you can put your own sort order in. So in this instance, we had April as the first year. And you also know the formula to create a financial quarter in Excel. So if you've got anything out of this tutorial, give us a thumbs up. Now, the next tutorial we're going to look at, next thing we're going to look at is the profit. So at the moment we've got the received. So if I just, over here we go. We've got the sum of received. We don't have how much money we've made. Why? Because we haven't included the expenses and a calculation within the pivot table. That's right. We're going to look at calculations within pivot tables and how that can help you with your accounts pivot table or your accounts spreadsheet. So I'm Simon from Computer Tutoring. I hope everyone's keeping safe. And I just want to say thank you so much for watching.